Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you 10 of my favorite Finder tricks. So tip number one is you can select a bunch of files or files and folders or anything in the Finder and go to File and create a new folder with the selection. And this creates a new folder, puts the files in there, and you can now change its name to whatever you want. If you look in there, you'll see those files. Tip number two is about batch renaming. And here I've got a folder filled with files that have very similar names. I'm going to select them all and go to File, and then you'll see it says Rename Four Items. And now I can replace text with something else. So I can replace the word test with the word example. There are other options as well for you to explore. Rename, and you can see it renamed all four of those. Tip number three is that you can use the undo command in the Finder. Now you're used to using undo, say, in word processors and image editing apps, but you can do it in the Finder as well. If I go to edit and you see undo, it even tells you what it's going to undo. I can undo that entire rename there. You can undo most things in the Finder and even go back multiple steps and keep going with Command Z or Shift Command Z to redo something that you just undid. Now you can also use undo to take a file that you put in the trash and get it back. But let's say it's not the last thing that you did. So let's say I'm going to put this file here in the trash and I rename something, and now undo will undo the rename, not take the thing back out of the trash. But I can look in the trash, see the things that are in there, select a file, and this is tip number four. I can use File Put Back. And Put Back, it remembers where the file originally came from and it puts it back there. And that'll work for all different files in the trash, even ones that you've thrown away a long time ago. It should still remember where they go and you should be able to put them back. Now tip number five will help you around a situation you may find yourself in where you've got something in the trash that you don't want to delete right now. You don't want to empty the trash, but you have a file that you want to delete. So you can select that file and go to File, and you've got Move to Trash, but if you hold the Option key down, it changes to Delete immediately. This will jump over the trash can step, immediately delete that file, and leave your trash alone. Now tip number six is about what happens when you create a new Finder window. It usually goes to a default place like All My Files, but let's say you want to change that. You can go to Finder Preferences, and under General you can select where new Finder windows should open to. So for instance, you can select your Documents folder, or you can use Other to choose just about any folder on your drive. So now when I create a new Finder window, it opens to where I want rather than All My Files or someplace else. Now tip number seven. Suppose that you are in a folder like this and you want to go to the folder that contains this folder. Well, there are two ways to do it. One is you can command click on the title here and then select the folder just above it or any folder you want. But a quick way to do it is to use Go and then in closing folder, or Command and an up arrow as the shortcut. And the great thing I like about this is that it will then highlight the folder that you were just in. So tip number eight involves these two buttons here, which a lot of people may not have noticed. They are back and forward buttons, and they work just like the back and forward buttons you may be used to using in your browser. So you can go back to the last folder you were at and continue to go back through the sequence, and you can go forward as well. So you can use your Finder window just like a browser window. It makes it really easy to stick with one Finder window when working with multiple locations. Now tip number nine also involves a function you may be used to using in other apps like word processors but didn't know you can use in the Finder. You can copy and paste. So for instance, I'm going to stick with one Finder window here, but I want to copy a file from this folder and paste it in here. Now typically I would open up a second Finder window, look at each folder, and drag and drop. But instead here I can go into this folder, select a file, go to Edit, Copy, then I can go up and then down into this folder and select Edit, Paste. And that creates a copy and places it here inside of this folder. Now you can also move files this way with, I'll undo here, and instead of pasting the item, I'll hold down the Option key and select Move Item here, and that moves it instead of copying it. And the idea of moving files instead of copying them brings us to tip number 10. Many Mac users run into the situation where you're looking at one folder on one hard drive and another folder in another drive. Say this is an external drive. If I were to go and drag and drop this file here, it creates a copy of it. And you could see the plus button there. It's because I'm moving it from one drive to the other, not two places in the same drive. But if I really did want to move this file, I have two choices. One is I could move it or copy it like that and then go back and delete this file. The other choice is I can drag it but hold down the command key as I do so, and you see the plus button goes away and it actually moves the file from one hard drive to another without any other steps needed. So there's a look at some of my favorite Finder tricks. If you've got Finder tricks you want to add to the list, leave them as comments to this post at macmost.com.